the sound and the lights. And now these guys in the hallway. On Thursday, they will play their first ever game in the month of May in history. Tonight, they play this latest day in the month of April. And for these guys, playing this late is still pretty early. They have gone to the final, and a fistful of them have won the Stanley Cup 8 years ago. There is a cannon that gets shot off here. Sound and lights, beacons of red, white, and blue await them as their goaltender, Sergei Bobrovsky, leads them down the hallway and out through the fog onto the ice. Mentally, we made mistakes we wouldn't make if we were a little fresher. We went 7 against Toronto. We had a day off, and we played 2 hard games. Now we've had 2 days off. I think we're going to be more representative. Do you agree?
We'll find out shortly, but the thing that tipped me off was when he said they all seem to be in a really good mood. This is a really very resilient group. They seem to find a way to summon up whatever energy they need and make whatever plays they need in order to climb back in it. As I said a couple of minutes ago, this is a critical game here. They need to get their act together and establish that they're the better team. Right now, this is even, Steven. You could go either way with this. Columbus grows with confidence every time it wins a game. Of course, they knocked off the tough Tampa Bay team, and now they're even on the road with Boston. They got to start thinking that they got a good chance at this.
Do you think there could be some jitters for the home team being in front of their crowd now in round 2?
I think there are. This is the first time most of these guys have been in the second round, but they can take that, use the energy, put it to their legs, get some hits, and they'll be fine.
And we were okay with the first cannon shot. We had an idea it was coming. Now we know for sure. We're going to hear from public address announcer Greg Murray.
Ladies and gentlemen, joining us for tonight's anthem, would you please welcome from the United States Army, 100-year-old World War II veteran, Lieutenant Colonel Escher Wengel. And now, to perform the Star Spangled Banner, please welcome Mr. Leo Welsh.
Leo! Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave o'er the land of the free.
And a man with a lot of stories who served standing next to him. Leo Welsh in the Star-Spangled Banner. Time for the Goldies, the starters presented by Honda. Brian Boucher.
Thank you very much, Doc. The goaltenders have been a positive story so far in these playoffs and especially in this series. Tuukka Rask, 38 saves in the loss. The double overtime loss in game two for the Boston Bruins. Looking to provide a chance for his team to win tonight on the road. And at the other end, Sergei Bobrovsky. Not as busy as Rask, 29 saves in the double overtime victory. He's provided some highlight reel saves so far in this series. See how it plays out tonight.
A venue change. Will the character change? The Hammers are not starting for either team. It is scoring line against scoring line to begin it all. Panarin is out there. Marchand is out there. Bergeron to take the draw. Opposite Pierre-Luc Dubois. And the Bruins, as they did in both of the first two games, win the draw, and it's slapped back in by Bergeron. And the chant of defense begins. Rushing over is Heinen. Puck played as far as Bergeron. Worked on back deeper, and Seth Jones to take it there. No one has played more than Jones. 33 minutes and a second average in the first two games, both requiring overtime. Atkinson brushed it behind, played along off of Panarin, jabbed on now for the outlet by Bergeron, taken on by Heinen, and the shot popped off Jones to the corner, and another shot is deflected up high, and that off Zach Werenski. Played by Panarin back to Werenski, and the first changes have taken place for both teams. Carson Kuhlman, number 83, is in. Chris Wagner is out for the Bruins. Ryan DeZingle, 19, is in for Columbus. Alexander Texier, the 19-year-old, is out. Those are the only changes. Poked along now, and it's Clifton lifting it back. End